There was a gentleman, and this is very recent, gentleman by the name of Nick Winton, not Jewish, stockbroker, went to Germany, a Czech, with a friend of his, discovered the situation. That was in 1939, situation as far as the kids were concerned. I don't think he could do much about the grown-ups. By which time, of course, the British government allowed children to come in without parents, on condition that once they were old enough that they still would not be allowed to work because of the unemployment in the 1930s. And he was responsible for bringing out about 600 odd Jewish children. Some with forged documents, and one of the documents I've got in there could well have been one of the forged ones, I don't know. I only discovered that, and now I'm a bit ahead of myself, I only discovered that when I happened to be switching on television. I'm not an Esther Ranson fan, but it was the end of one of her programs, and they were interviewing a gentleman, and who happened to be Nicholas Winton. It was discovered, he had lots of papers, and I've got some of them somewhere, who he wanted to leave them to posterity. And it was suggested that he got in touch with Rupert Murdoch, who would possibly be able to, you know, find something. Rupert Murdoch, being Rupert Murdoch, decided there's a story to be told. He then owned the Sunday Pictorial. And it was the Sunday, because at the end of this program, we've subsequently met Nicholas Winton, and said anybody who's got, who thinks they're on Nicholas Winton list should phone so-and-so. So he said, well, you've got one of these documents. So at the end of the program, I phoned up, and I thought I was being put through the BBC. But anyway, the first thing, the chap, he said, do you ever read a Sunday Pictorial? I said, I don't read that rubbish. To be told that he was from the Sunday Pictorial. Anyway, they came back within about 10 minutes to confirm that my sister and my name are on it. So we are, in fact, one of the Nicholas Winton kids.